Well, then welcome back to Couples in Christ. I'm Pastor Tim.
Hi, Patty.
We are on day 7 of our Love Dare Challenge, and today's theme is Love Believes the Best, and our Bible verse is from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 7.
This is what it says. Love never gives up, never loses faith, is always hopeful, and endures through every circumstance.
You know, every time I hear that Love Never Gives Up, I think of the Rick Astley song, Never Gonna Give You Up.
Oh, dear. We started that way today already.
Already. Yep. It's one of those days. Well, in the deep and private corridors of your heart, there is a room. It's called the Appreciation Room. It's where your thoughts go when you encounter positive and encouraging things about your spouse. And every so often, you enjoy visiting this very special place.
On the walls are written kind words and phrases describing the good attributes of your mate. These may include characteristics like honest, intelligent, maybe they're a diligent worker, a wonderful cook, or they have beautiful eyes.
Thank you.
You're welcome. They are phrases, things, here we go. They are things you've discovered about your husband or wife that have embedded themselves in your memory.
Yeah, so when you think about these things, your appreciation for your spouse begins to increase and grow. In fact, the more time you spend meditating on these positive attributes, typically the more grateful you are about your spouse.
You know, and a lot of these things that are in the appreciation room were probably written there in the very beginning stages of your relationships. Things that attracted you to your spouse that you really liked and respected. They were true and honorable and good, and you spent a great deal of time dwelling here in this room. And then you probably got married.
Right. But once you're married or you've been in a relationship a long time, you may have found that you don't visit this special room as often as you once did. And that's because there is another competing room nearby. Down another dark corridor of your heart lies the depreciation room. And unfortunately, you and I visit there as well.
Yes, and there's stuff written on the walls of there too. But there are things that bother and irritate you about your spouse. These things were placed there out of irritation, hurt feelings, frustration, the disappointment of unmet expectations.
This room is lined with the weaknesses and failures of your husband or wife. Their bad habits, the hurtful words, and poor decisions are written in large letters that cover the walls from one end of that room to the other.
So if you hang out in this room long enough, you can get very depressed and start expressing things like, my wife is so selfish, or my husband can be such a jerk, or maybe even start to think, you know, I think I just married the wrong person.
Some people write very hateful things in this room where tell-off statements are rehearsed for the next argument that they're just waiting to start. Emotional injuries fester here, adding more scathing remarks to the already covered walls. It's where ammunition is kept for the next big fight, and bitterness is allowed to spread like a terminal disease. People fall out of love in this room.
We really want you to know this, that spending time in the depreciation room kills marriages. Divorces are plotted in this room, and violent plans are schemed. The more time you spend in this place, the more your heart devalues your spouse.
It begins the moment you walk in that door, from home, for work, wherever, and you care for them lessons with every second that ticks by.
You may say, hey, but these things are true.
Yes, but so are all the things in the appreciation room. Everyone fails and has areas that need growth. Everyone has unresolved issues and hurts and personal baggage. This is just a sad aspect of being a human. We have all sinned, but we have this unfortunate tendency to downplay our own negative attributes while putting our partner's failures under a magnifying glass.
True. So let's get down to the real issue here. Love knows about the depreciation room. It doesn't live in denial that it's there, it exists, but love chooses not to live there.
So you must decide to stop running into this room and lingering there after every frustrating event in your relationship, because it does you no good and drains the joy out of your marriage.
Love chooses to believe the best about people. It gives them the benefit of the doubt. It refuses to fill in the unknowns with negative assumptions. And when our worst hopes are proven to be true, because that happens, love makes every effort to deal with them and move forward. As much as possible, love focuses on the positive.
It's time to start thinking differently. It's time to let love lead your thoughts and your focus. The only reason you should glance into the door of depreciation of that room is to know how to pray for your spouse, because that's their weaknesses and baggage. And the only reason you should ever go into that room at all is to write "covered in love" in huge letters across all four walls.
We need to move right on into the appreciation room to settle down and make it our home. And as we choose to meditate on the positives, we'll learn that many more wonderful character qualities could be written across those walls. I'm sure over the years you're married that there are things that you found positives about your spouse that can be written in there.
Right. After all, your spouse is a living, breathing, endless book to be read. Dreams and hopes have yet to be realized. Talents and abilities may be discovered in the future like a hidden treasure. But the choice to explore them starts with a decision by you.
You must develop the habit of writing in your negative thoughts and focusing on the positive attributes of your mate. This is a crucial step as you learn to lead your heart to truly love your spouse. It's a decision that you make, whether they deserve it or not.
So for today's dare, I want you to get two sheets of paper. And on the first one, spend a few minutes writing out positive things about your spouse, and hopefully this will take a while. Then do the same with all of the negative things on that second sheet of paper, and we pray this doesn't take as long. Place both sheets in a secret place for another day. Now, there is a purpose and plan for each of these sheets of paper, but at some point during the rest of today, or whatever day you do this, pick a positive attribute from that first list. And then thank your spouse for having that specific characteristic.
Note, whatever you do, that negative list, don't give it to your spouse.
No.
Put it away somewhere.
Yeah, hide it.
You're going to do something privately with it.
Yes.
You are never going to give this list to your spouse.
Yes.
So don't give it to them.
Good point.
Okay?
Good asterisk.
Don't do that. That is not going to help the love there process.
That is not helpful. Not helpful.
We do not want to share the depreciation room with our spouse.
Nope.
No. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we know that the appreciation room is where you want us to dwell.
Help us to stay away from the depreciation room.
We know that with your help, we can cover everything in that room with love.
This is exactly what you do with us.
Help us copy your example and show our spouses compassion and forgiveness.
Amen. Well, that's it for our Love Dare today. We'll see you again tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye.
Love each other.